The gospel according to Luke.
Amen.
The gospel according to Luke. The 22nd chapter. Luke. 22nd chapter of Luke. 22nd chapter of Luke. And we will start reading at the 15th verse. Start reading at the 15th verse. Luke, 22nd chapter, 15th verse. And he said unto them, I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say unto you, I will not any more eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took the cup and gave thanks and said, take this and divide it among yourselves. For I say unto you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God shall come. And he took bread and gave thanks and brake it and gave unto them, saying, this is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. Likewise also, the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new testament in my blood, which is shed for you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. Now we have chosen to focus mainly on the 19th verse and the 20th verse. The 19th verse says, and he took bread and gave thanks and brake it and gave unto them, saying, this is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. And the 20th verse says, likewise also the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood which is shed for you. Now we would like to use mainly the 19th verse for our message today, but we will certainly end on the 20th verse. The 19th verse, we find three sacred symbols, which would make fitting chapter beginning for Jesus' life. Mm-hmm. Now the first one is he took.
Okay.
The second one, he breaks. And the third one, he gave. He gave. Now, the whole gospel story is lusted with a beautiful self-denial on the part of Jesus Christ. In John, the 8th chapter and the 28th verse, he said, when ye have lifted up the Son of Man, then shall ye know that I am he, and that I do nothing of myself, but as my Father has taught me, I speak these things.
Yeah.
It was his attitude to his Father, who also, my friend, at times, it was his attitude towards men.
Yes, it was.
Now John, the 17th chapter in the 6th verse said, I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me. And they have kept thy word.
Yeah.
He did not consider it unbecoming or unnecessary for him to accept the poor and seemingly inadequate gifts of common folks. He gladly accepted the tender ministry of Mary and Joseph, his God and family. He did not scorn such temple education as Nazareth had the law. He took for himself his intimate disciples, 12 undistinguished men, and he turned the world upside down.
Yes,
he took a fisherman's house. took five loaves and two fishes, a little lad had to offer, and he fed 5,000 men, not counting women and children. He took little Tush, the child that's running out of the church door right now. Amen. He took those church in his arms and he blessed them.
Amen.
He took the form of a servant to make us sons of God.
Yes, he did.
He took a towel, loaded, and washed your disciples' feet.
Yes, he did.
Some bread. Some of the people perfect in the broken. The sacrifice is he accepts a broken and contrite heart. Those who are broken in wealth and broken in self-will and broken in doubt and ambition and rude repetition and broken in thy affection, and those who are despised now and seen ugly and the Holy Spirit, my friend, is seizing upon thy person and using them for God's glory. Peter had in the fourth chapter in 1 Peter, behold, think it not strange concerning the fire of trial, which is to try you, as though some strange things happen unto you. But rejoice, inasmuch as he partaketh of Christ's suffering, that when his glory shall be revealed, he may be glad also with exceeding joy. So in order for us to be purified, the fire of affliction must come upon us, and our will must be brought into conformity to the will of God. Amen. Joy, joy, joy!
Yes, Lord.
God sees it best to put us under the course of discipline, which is essential for us before we are fit subject for the blessings we crave.
Yes.
He took, he prayed, he gave.
Yes.
The message of grace is to give.
Yes.
Well, John 3:16 said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. His love, my friend, has no limit. His grace has no measure. His power has no boundary. Out of his infinite riches in Jesus, God has given and given and given again. As we have prayed two prayers today, I heard about last night. Many went to bed. I went to bed last night, boy. 82 years old. And babies, teenagers, young as us, many thousands didn't wake up.
That's right.
Many thousands. That was better, probably by nature, than I am by practice. But I'm here.
Yeah.
The gift of grace, compared with the gift of God, material gifts fade like the stars at sunlight.
Come on, yes.
Think for whom Christ was given.
Yes.
He was given for you.
Yes, he was.
Think of the shame and suffering of the cross.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, my Lord. God's love is expensive.
Yes.
In his sacrifice.
Yeah.
All could not find words to describe the nature of the gift of Jesus.
Yeah.
In 2 Corinthians 9 chapter and 15 verse, he called him God's unspeakable gift.
Yeah.
And in Romans 8 chapter 32 verse, he states, he that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things.
Yes.
That's some grace.
Amen.
Jesus' whole life was a taking, a giving, and a giving.
John
12 verse says, as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God.
Yes.
Even to them that believe on his name.
Yes.
John 18, chapter 15, verse says, I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. Then also John 13:34, he says, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another. now in this thanksgiving that Paul had in mind, he said in Galatians 6 chapter 20, I am crucified with Christ.
That's right.
Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. In the life which I now live in the flesh, yes. I live by the faith of the Son of God, woo, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Yes, yes.
Jesus Christ gave all. Jesus Christ gave all.
Yes, he did.
He gave his head to the crown of thorns.
Yes, he did.
He gave his back to be
bruised
with the Roman soldiers. He gave his shoulders to be draped with the robe of martyrs. He gave his mother to the apostles.
Yes, he did.
John. He gave his hands and feet to be transfixed and nailed to the old rugged cross, the symbol of suffering and shame. He gave his blood to the earth for the remission of sin. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Yes, yes, that is a boundary.
Yes.
Drawing from Emmanuel, baby.
Hallelujah.
At this point, beneath that blood, lose all thy guilt is saved.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Opposed to the unsaved today, have you been washed? Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power?
Yeah.
Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Yes.
Are you fully trusting in His grace?
Say it.
His power?
Oh,
are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Yeah.
So lay aside the garment that are stained with sin.
Yes.
And be washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, there's a fountain for the soul that is unclean.
Yes.
There's blood that flows from a many veins, my friend, that is cleansing blood.
Yes.
The blood that flows from Emmanuel veins is atoning blood.
Yes.
The blood that flows from Emmanuel veins is sanctifying blood.
Yes.
The blood that flows from Emmanuel veins is saving blood.
Yes.
You have been washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Yes.
You will live for your blood. He died on the cross of Calvary for our sins. He rose up from the dead for our justification. He went back to glory for our eternal preparation.
Yeah.
My friend, he's alive today.
He's alive.
I am he who lived and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore.
Yeah.
And he said, because I live, he also to be.
Yes.
God sent his son, my friend. They call him Jesus.
All
he gave his blood of healing.
Yes.
He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there.
Yes, it
is. He
yes.
Because he lived, I can face tomorrow.
Yes.
Because he lived, Paul Peter told
him.
Because I just because